Hola y bienvenidos a otra lección del español 2. Now, about 10 lessons ago, 8 to 10 lessons ago, I don't remember, we did a lesson on direct object pronouns. You remember direct object pronouns are pronouns, well, pronouns take the place of a noun, throwing in it or them instead of saying always the name of the item. So instead of saying, leí el libro, tú leíste el libro, él leyó el libro, instead of saying el libro over and over and over, we can replace it with a pronoun, lo, it. Directly receives the action of the verb. In the previous lesson, we focused on lo, la, it, los and las, them. In this lesson, we're still doing direct object pronouns. It's still the same thing, except we're working more with me and te, nos and os. And the lo and the la, instead of just being it and them, is now him, her, or them still. So before we go any further, I'm going to recycle part of that previous lesson. We're going to do it as review. I've cut out a little bit of it. We're going to use it as review to refresh what these direct object pronouns are. And then we're going to have a little bit of stuff specifically from this chapter. And, well, we'll just go from there. Okay, we'll look at a sentence like this. Matt gave the book to John. Where is our subject? Okay, our subject is going to be, of course, Matt. He is the one that is performing the action. He's the one conjugating the verb. Okay, here's our verb. So we have our subject, Matt, and now we have the book to John. We've got two elements here. Which one is our direct object pronoun? Which one is directly receiving the action of the verb? Now some people might say, well, it was given to John, so John is receiving the book. No, John is receiving the book. He's not receiving the action. What do you mean, senor? Well, that's an easy way to do it is look at the word gave. Look at the verb. And you ask yourself, what is being given? Well, Matt is giving, but what is being given? The book is what is being given. So the book is the one that is directly receiving the action of the verb. Okay? John, by the way, is indirectly receiving the action. He's receiving the book. But indirect object pronouns, we'll deal with that in another lesson. So I'm just going to go ahead and cross this one off for now. Okay, so Matt gave the book. The book is being given. It is a direct object. And in this state, it's a noun. It's still just a noun. And we ask ourselves, well, what's a pronoun? How do we make it a direct object pronoun? Well, you'll remember that, you know, canned response again from English class, pronouns replace nouns. Yes. So what would replace... What would we replace the book with if we were to replace it with something? Well, probably with it. Matt gave it to John. Okay, let's look at the pronouns in Spanish. I'm sorry, the direct object pronouns in Spanish, because we've got several. We've got reflexive and we've got subject pronouns, but right at the direct object pronouns. Me, te, me, you, lo, and la both mean it, nos, us, nos means us in this case, os, y'all in Spain or you guys, and los and las is the plural of lo and la. So if lo and la mean it, what is the plural of it? I have students that say its, but no, you don't just add an s to make it plural, it changes to them. So me, te, lo, la, me, you, it, nos, os, los, las, us, you guys, them. And you notice that it's lo and la, los and las. By this point, it would probably be pretty basic to figure out that lo is the masculine, la is the feminine. Okay, let's get to one of these. Direct object pronouns, we've got the list of them there. Now, I'm talking to somebody and I say, hey, Pablo es mi amigo. You know, what are we gonna say there? Pablo es mi amigo. Do you know him? What would we say for him? Lo, easy. Pablo es mi amigo. ¿Lo conoces? You know him? Now we could say tú lo conoces or lo conoces tú. That would probably sound better, but yeah, lo is him. You know what? I'm sorry. I just realized that when we went through these, I just called it, but it's also him and her. Him, her, it. Okay. My bad. I forgot about calling the person a person. Okay, next one. No hice mi tarea. I didn't do my homework. Tengo que hacer, I didn't do my homework. I have to do it. Okay, so what is the it gonna be for homework? Okay, well, it's going to be la, because it's la tarea, tengo que hacerla. Whoa, wait a second here, because on this last slide, we put it before the verb. Now, in this slide, we're connecting it to the end. What's going on here? Well, just like we did in with reflexive verbs, with reflexive verbs, we learned that the pronoun either goes before the conjugated verb or connected to the infinitive. Once again, before the conjugated verb or connected to the infinitive. What was that? Before the conjugated verb or connected to the infinitive in most cases. Okay, let's take a look at the next one. Okay, so we took what was similar in the last one and we just switched it around a little. No hice mi tarea, I didn't do my homework. Instead of saying tengo que hacer it, now we're going to put it before the conjugated instead of connected to the infinitive. So what are we going to put there? No hice mi tarea, la tengo que hacer. I have to do it. Okay, one of our words specific to this chapter is esperar, to hope, to wait. And this lends itself really well to direct object pronouns. Because if I want to say, I wait for you, I always wait for you. You would say, yo siempre espero. I always wait. But how do we say you? Now, esperar, by the way, has the for built into it. I always wait for you. Yo siempre blank espero. Yo siempre te espero. Or let's switch it around. Let's say your parents say, I'm sorry, they always wait for me. My parents always wait for me. Mis padres siempre esperan. My parents always wait for, and now we want to say me. Mis padres siempre me esperan. Okay, let's try another. Let's try llevar. Llevar means to wear or to carry. And when you're talking about transportation, it's like give somebody a ride. So if I want to say, oh, yesterday my sister took me to school. Ayer mi hermana llevó a la escuela. She took to school. She carried to school. Who did she take? Well, she took me. Me llevó a la escuela. Tomorrow, my dad is going to take her to school. Mañana, mi papá va a llevar a la escuela. He's going to take to school. Who's he going to take? Her. Va a llevar la. Now, remember that la can go connected to the infinitive, va a llevarla, or before the conjugated. La va a llevar. Okay? Let me see if I've got another one here. Oh, ayudar. Ayudar is another good one here. Ayudar means to help. So if I want to say, oh, they always help us. Ellos siempre ayudan. They always help. But I want to say they always help us. Siempre blank ayudan. What would it be? Well, it would be siempre nos ayudan. Okay, guys, that's your quick review of direct object pronouns. We're going to work with these in class. I've already got some exercises and activities ready to go for you. So I'm glad you did this little review. It's going to help you out immensely once you're in the classroom again. Hasta la próxima vez. Ciao.